just waiting on the line, just outside. Ooh. Will you always be my love? Will you always be my love?
Thank you. Gathered today to celebrate one of the happiest moments in the lives of Andy and Kaslin. For on this day, they affirmed before witnesses of heaven and earth that they believe God has purposed that they should share life in the holy bonds of marriage. Let's ask God's blessing over this ceremony. Please pray with me. Father, we thank you for this beautiful evening, for this day that you have created. We simply rejoice in it. God, thank you for all that you've done in Andy and Kaslin's life to even bring them here today to celebrate such a joyous day and occasion. And Lord, I pray that in the next few moments that you would etch in their hearts the commitment, the vows that they take before you and before friends and family here this evening. We want to commit this ceremony and this night to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You can have a seat. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
All right, here we go. You ready? Okay. Andy and Kaslin. As we gather here today, I want to listen to this God kind of love that's provided for us as laid out in Ephesians chapter 3 in the Bible. And Jessica's going to read this for us. Please go ahead.
From Ephesians 3:16-21. I pray out of his glorious riches, he may strengthen you with power through his spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the Lord's holy people to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than we all ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us. To be in him, the glory of the church. According to his power that is at work within us, to be him, the glory in the church, and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. All who come to the marriage altar desire to have this kind of love in the marriage. It begins by receiving Jesus as your Savior and Lord, then by placing Him at the center of your life and your marriage. Truly, the nearest place to heaven in this world is a home filled with this kind of love that comes straight from God. And I know both of you desire to have a marriage that is at least a glimpse of heaven on earth. A marriage that is filled with joy in your home, that brings honor to Christ, and that goes the distance. I want to share with you briefly four powerful pillars needed for a healthy marriage that goes the distance. Because my prayer, as you get to the end of your life, and Kaslin's healthier than Andy, so I'm thinking maybe she's going to outlast him, and we'll see. But to be able to say, you know what, stand over and say, he said that he would, and he did. He said that he would, and he did. And that one day at the end of your life, Andy, you get to end your life, you say, you know what, she said that she would, and she did. So let me share these with you. Here's number one, is the power of partnership. In the very first marriage, Genesis chapter 2, verse 18 says, "The Lord God said, it's not good for man to be alone. I'll make a helper suitable for him. But for Adam, no suitable helper was found." God knew what Adam needed was more than a golf buddy, more than someone just to surf with, although that's a good thing too. But just so much more than that. And so the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man. And he brought her to the man in the very first marriage. Verse 23, it says, "The man said, this is now bone of my bones, flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called," whoa, "man." Isn't that right, Andy? Amen. All right, I thought I could get an amen from Andy. "Whoa, man, for she was taken out of man." It's the power of partnership. Notice that God took a rib from the side of Adam, not from the top of his head for her to trample upon him, not something from his foot for him to trample upon her, but from the rib, from the innermost and the intimate part close to your heart, someone to come alongside of, to do life with, to journey along in this life with. And it's a 100% all-in mutual commitment that you're making today, and that you can choose to be a helper or a hinderer to what God wants to do in each other's lives. One way we can say it also is that you can be the wind beneath each other's wings or the pain in the rear, okay? So we want to choose the first one. It's the power of partnership. It's that your marriage is as good as you together choose to make it. Listen to Ecclesiastes 4, 9 and 10. "Two are better than one because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up, but pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up." In short, the power of partnership is just about helping each other up. When you fall, when you make mistakes, and when you realize that you've married an imperfect person, that you help them up when those things happen. Here's the second one, is the power of purity. It says, verse 25, "The man and his wife were both naked and they felt no shame." No shame. It was a place where they both were bringing it, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. This place where it was this all-in 100%. And this is where, men, I want to encourage you today. There's a saying that says, "Where secrets live, intimacy dies. But where intimacy lives, secrets die." So I say, man, you let everything else before your life, it dies today. That you're coming to this altar, you're letting everything else go. And that today you're choosing to focus on what the best of what you two are bringing together today. And choosing to believe by God's grace, the best is yet to come in your lives and together as you make this commitment together. So you can choose to make each other better or bitter. But the difference is I. It's the letter I. It's what I choose to do and I choose to bring to this relationship to make it better. It's this power of purity and holding no secrets and living an intimate life together. Here's number three, is the power of pursuit. It says, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. It's the power of pursuit. So I just encourage whatever you did, Andy, to bring Kaslin to you and work in your awesome game and how incredible you are, man. It doesn't stop. What you did, he's got to continue to do those things. And Kaslin, the way you flipped your hair, the way you did what you did to catch Andy's eye, that you continue to do those things. What I want to say is that what you did in dating, you continue to do those things in marriage. Because the grass isn't greener on the other side. And we've talked so much together about these things, is that the grass is greener wherever you water it. So water your garden, water your grass, see what you do to make your marriage flourish. And that if you ever don't like what you're getting in your marriage, then look at what you are getting. And look what you are giving within that relationship. So I want to encourage you. James chapter 4 verse 17 says, anyone then who knows the good he ought to do and doesn't do it sins. So within your relationship, if you think something good, say it. If you think something special, do it. And if you ever want something different, be it. Because if you want what few have, you must be willing to do what few do. And what few do is pursue each other throughout their lives, throughout their marriage, from beginning to end. Now, I'm going to help my man Andy out, okay? You need to know this too, that you may say, oh man, I did something nice last week. But what you need to know is that all points evaporate at midnight. Can I get an amen from any women in the house? You see what I'm saying? They got that. All right? I just helped you out, man. Okay? But seriously, that pursuit is not once a week. It's not once a month. It is a daily thing. Pursue each other, Andy and Kaslin. Here's the last one, is the power of priorities. Who was the master creator? Who was the master designer at work in Genesis 2? Who is the one that knew what man needed and brought woman to man? It was God. He is. Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 says, seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all of these things will be given to you as well. If you ever look and say, man, our marriage is not working, the first place to look is, do we have mixed priorities? What have we put before our relationship with God? Do not allow good things to keep you from the best things that God has in your life. Keeping those right priorities. A great marriage isn't built in a day. It's built upon what you do daily. And daily, seek first God and His kingdom and His will for your lives. Listen to Matthew chapter 6, verse 24. Jesus said, therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who builds his house on the rock. Today, you're building a wedding, building a marriage on a rock. And it says this, the rain came down, the streams rose, the winds blew and beat against that house, yet it did not fall because it had as its foundation on the rock. There's this old hymn that says, on Christ, the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Every relationship ends up somewhere, but few end up somewhere on purpose. Allow your relationship to end up somewhere on purpose because you sought first God and His kingdom and His will and building your marriage on the rock who is Jesus. To have a marriage that is filled with joy, that brings honor to Christ and that goes the distance, seek to live out these powerful pillars of partnership, purity, pursuit, and the right priority. And so a part of having this Christ-centered marriage is understanding your unique roles. So Andy, I challenge you today, my man, to receive Kaslin to your side, to love her, to care for her as Christ loved the church and gave Himself up for her, and to open your heart and life to her and to be the spiritual leader in your home. You may not know this, Andy, but Kaslin, at the age of 10 years old, started praying for her husband. Every single night, she said her prayers before bed, and she prayed that his heart, whomever he was, would be preparing and leading up to be the husband for her. She prayed all the way up until the day that she met you. The moment she met you, she knew you were the man that she had been praying for so long. Not every young girl at the age of 10 could say that, that they're praying for their future husband to be molded into a man of God. But before she knew you, she was already praying for you. It's awesome. Kaslin, I also want to encourage you to challenge you to receive Andy to your side, to love him and care for him and to respect him as a supportive and loving wife. When Andy first met you, he said he went home that night and told his parents that he just met his future wife. Amen. And when they first started hanging out, Kaslin came to Andy's mom's retirement party after he had invited her. Remember that moment? And it says she walked in unknowing that she would be swarmed with meeting everyone important to Andy in his life that night. And everyone that she met instantly fell in love with her. But man, what really sealed the deal that night was later that night when she stayed late into the party and his dog Cody fell asleep in her lap. Right, Andy? Man. So believing, though, that Andy and Kaslin understand their unique roles and how God has brought them together, believing they do not take this step lightly, and believing they accept each other in a spirit of prayer, they will now exchange marriage vows. Mark chapter 10, Jesus said, "At the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate." Here we go, Andy.
Let's do this.
All right, man. I, Andy.
I, Andy.
Take you, Kaslin.
Take you, Kaslin.
As my lawful wife.
As my lawful wife.
To walk beside me when things are good.
To walk beside me when things are good.
And when things are bad.
And when things are bad.
I pledge to you my undying love.
I pledge to you my undying love.
And constant faithfulness.
And constant faithfulness.
All I have or hope to have.
All I have or hope to have.
I give to you.
I give to you.
As my life partner.
As my life partner.
I pledge you my help.
I pledge you my help.
My support.
My support.
My love.
My love.
And my prayers.
And my prayers.
I pledge to remain faithfully yours.
I pledge to remain faithfully yours.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Kaslin, mm-hmm. You ready? Yes. I, Kaslin.
I, Kaslin.
Take you, Andy.
Take you, Andy.
As my lawful husband.
As my lawful husband.
To walk beside me when things are good.
To walk beside me when things are good.
And when things are bad.
And when things are bad.
I pledge you my undying love.
I pledge you my undying love.
And constant faithfulness.
And constant faithfulness.
All I have or hope to have.
All I have or hope to have.
I give to you as my life partner.
I give to you as my life partner.
I pledge you my help.
I pledge you my help.
My support.
My support.
My love.
My love.
And my prayers.
And my prayers.
I pledge to remain faithfully yours.
I pledge to remain faithfully yours.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
You have just shared some beautiful and powerful vows. You will now give and exchange rings as symbols of these vows of faith and love. A marriage ring says, "I love someone special." It's an outward symbol of an inner commitment. Also, the rings are formed in circles, symbolizing the unending dimension of your love to never separate and also the eternal love of God. Andy, would you take this ring and place it on Kaslin's left hand? Let me hold one. Yeah. Okay. Hold it there and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And with it, I give you my faithfulness.
And with it, I give you my faithfulness.
And my devotion.
And my devotion.
All I have or hope to have.
All I have or hope to have.
I give to you as my partner in life.
I give to you as my partner in life.
I promise.
I promise.
To remain faithfully yours forever.
To remain faithfully yours forever.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And with it, I give you my faithfulness.
And with it, I give you my faithfulness.
And my devotion.
And my devotion.
All I have or hope to have.
All I have or hope to have.
I give to you as my partner in life.
I give to you as my partner in life.
And I promise to remain faithfully yours forever.
I promise to remain faithfully yours forever.
Amen. Would you join me in praying together? Father, we thank you so much for this amazing couple. Thank you for these vows that were just shared, the rings that were exchanged. And God, I pray that they never forget this moment. God, I pray that in the good times and bad times, in the ups and downs of life, may they never forget, God, what you are etching on their hearts and their minds. God, these vows that they have taken, that may they get to the end of their lives and say, you know what? He said that he would and he did. She said that she would and she did. And so, Lord, we thank you so much for what you have done, bringing this beautiful, amazing couple together. And thank you in advance for what you're going to do in the days ahead. We are believing the best is yet to come for this amazing couple. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Andy and Kaslin, because you have exchanged sacred vows, because you have given rings as symbols of your commitment to marriage, it's my privilege to pronounce that from this day forward, in the sight of God and man, you are now husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no man separate. Andy, you may kiss your bride. All right. It's my privilege to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Andy and Kaslin Green. Thank you.
Mr. and Mrs. Tucker! Green, I am sorry. Mr. and Mrs. Green, if I could be the breezer we hail so much, the bass drum beating way down deep in your chest, if I could be the voice on your radio, then I could be your long ride home. The dollar in your pocket and the peaceful in your sleep, then I'd be what you mean to me. Standing here watching you, turning every head in this crowded room.
Oh yeah, make some noise for our bride and groom. Come on, y'all.
We're just so blessed and thankful you could all be here tonight. This is not a speech, this is a welcome toast. So the Kleenex is in my pocket for now. And I just so grateful for each and every one of you in our lives. We are blessed beyond imagine, and it's just been the perfect, most beautiful day of our life. So. Thank you, honey. You and Kaslin for doing such an absolutely amazing job. And this place looks wonderful. Let's have a great time tonight. Let's party, let's eat, and just have fun. All right? Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Yeah, please remain seated.
So I was telling the girls last night that I've been so excited about today for so long, like way, way before that ring was on your finger, Kaz, that now that it's here, I feel like I don't know how to act. Like we've just been so, so, so excited about it. And I want you to know, Kaz, that it is such an honor to be up here honoring you. And as my friend, I know that everyone in here knows that, but to me, you are kind, you're pure-hearted, you're thoughtful, and your friendship always points me to Jesus. And This is a really unique situation for me because I don't just have great things to say about Kaz. I don't just have great things to say about Andy. I have great things to say. I mean, you're great too, Andy. But I have great things to say about you two as a couple because Kaslin and I became friends right when you guys were getting to know each other. And so I feel like I have this unique perspective in being able to watch your love story unfold. And particularly in the last year when Andy chose the much more difficult route of deciding mid-career to become a firefighter. And that wasn't just a decision he made for himself, it was a decision that he made for Kaz, for their family. And watching the way that they sought the Lord and prayed and just wanted to honor God and wanted to make this decision for their family was so neat because it really sets the stage for the rest of, for their marriage. And throughout this process, I watched Andy learn how to be a husband to Kaslin, learning how to provide, to protect, to lead their family. And I watched Kaslin learn how to support and encourage Andy in this new thing that was really challenging at times. And her support and her love never ever wavered. And that was so beautiful to watch. And I want you guys to know that I know we have really, really great times ahead and we have so much fun with you guys, but on a deeper level, I know that John and I are so committed to praying for you guys, to stand by you guys in great times and in hard times. And I know that you guys have such a solid foundation in the Lord and nothing else matters. So I love you two. Everyone raise a glass. We're going to have the best party ever because they're the best people ever. I love you so much.
Hi, everybody. I'm Brittany. I have a speech written. I'm sorry. I'm more comfortable with this. I'm the lucky girl Kaz asked to be your maid of honor about 6 months ago. I want to start off by congratulating you two on your special day and by thanking you guys for allowing me to play such an important role in your day. I am honored. When I look at you two, I think back to how you guys met 5 years ago and the journey you've had together. From their first glances at each other at Barney and Barney, to smiling each other and admiring each other from afar, to establishing a friendship and relationship that many of us knew was perfect from the start. What a fun experience it's been watching you two over the years. I know my best friend has found her perfect match, and I know their relationship is built on a firm foundation of faith, love, and happiness. You two have a wonderful adventure ahead of you. Kaz, you're beautiful. I was so happy the day you asked me to be your maid of honor, and I've loved all the detailed emails, picture text messages asking what dress to wear, and calls of desperation along the way. I have thoroughly enjoyed being at your side throughout the wedding process. Finding the dress might have been a difficult decision, but saying yes to Andy when he asked you to marry him was definitely not. I still remember the first time I met you at the deli at USD. You were so kind and graceful. Your bright smile and great spirit makes everyone you meet immediately want to call you their friend. I have so many memories from over the years. Our girls' trip to Vegas as single ladies back in the day, our dinner dates and slumber parties, weekends in Palm Desert, and so much more. Thank you for giving the true meaning to the word friend, and thanks for all the wonderful memories we've made throughout the past 9 years. I can't wait to make many more. Andy, you look sharp as ever. First of all, thanks for making my friends so happy. I admire your adventurous and curious ways, and I'm always happy to hear about your latest guys' trips or vacation plans with Kaz. I've always hoped you would find somebody who is equally as kind-hearted, loyal, honest, and considerate as her, and I can truly say that you're that guy. I'm so glad your paths crossed. All in all, I see you both being successful in everything you do, both on your own and professionally and together as a couple in marriage. You're both so strong, smart, and determined. Each of you are passionate about all that you apply yourselves to. With your faith in God, with your professions, with your love for your families and your many friendships. You both are so giving of your talents and you live life to the fullest. You never forget to have fun and you always enjoy the good times in life. I look forward to all the memories yet to be made. We've had some amazing times, but I'm sure the best is still ahead. My wish for Andy and Kaslin is that they have a continued friendship and partnership filled with compassion and laughter. Through the years, I hope your love for each other will deepen and grow. Thank you for including me on your journey. I wish you the very best, and I love both of you so much. I don't have a glass, but will you raise them with me? And cheers to the happy couple. Love you guys.
All right. So I don't want to keep you guys from your food too long, but I first want to say, how much did Andy and Kaslin nail that first dance? Let's all have a hand for that. So for all of you guys that don't know me, my name's Dave. I've been a lifelong friend of Andy's, and I'm really tremendously honored that you wanted to have me by your side tonight as your best man, or at least the best choice out of this group of bozos over here, so. It's not saying much, but. Also, extremely honored that you trusted me enough to come up here and share some personal stories about you in front of everyone that you care about, so. You know, I'd first off like to thank the Green family and the Tucker family for all the tremendous effort and dedication they put into putting this just magnificent event together. Truly beautiful up to this point. And for all of you guys that traveled, you know, far and near to come here, just looking out here, seeing all of your guys' faces and how many people are here, it's just a testament to the, you know, the love we have for Andy and Kaslin, and, you know, it's a testament to how much faith we have in them as a union, so here's to them. So, there's still more, So, Andy and I go way back. I first met Andy back in middle school, back making trouble in the back of Mr. Jeffrey's classroom in seventh grade algebra, popping staples in the back of his old Macintosh computer. Until one day, when he went to turn it on, popped like a Chinese firecracker, and all of our grades just scattered into the ether, so I have you to thank for that, eh? Thanks, Andy. Yeah, but we actually didn't really become really good friends until high school, and what started out as just a mutual love of the sport of surfing, you know, turned into a steadfast and immutable friendship, and I think part of the reason that I've stayed friends with Andy so long is just his contagious enthusiasm and lust for life. I've never known him once in my life to say no to a new experience, or to, you know, have an adventure, or anything that would enrich his life. And, you know, you're a great guy. First time I heard about Kaslin, Andy explained this goddess that he'd met at Barney and Barney. So obviously my expectations were pretty high, but when finally Andy mustered up enough courage to actually ask her out and I got to meet Kaslin, she far exceeded all my expectations. She is genuinely one of the most kind-hearted and down-to-earth people I've ever met, and the perfect match for Andy. You couldn't have found a better one. Happy for you. So, it's usually at this point that I would wish you guys luck, but to be honest, you guys don't need it. I can say with infallible certainty that you guys will have no challenges ahead of you. I know you guys are meant to be for each other, and you guys are wonderful. Thank you. Now let's raise our glasses and a toast to Mr. and Mrs. Green. Mazel tov.
Yeah.
A very, very, very special night for me tonight. And most of you don't know this, but for the last 10 years, her Uncle Scott has called her the tallest Tucker. And tonight, I regain that title because you are now a Green. So this is a big night for me. Very big. Sure. I'm standing up. Thanks to everybody for coming. I know a lot of people have come from far away, from Japan. We have Joey Baker. We've got Minnesota, North Carolina, the East Coast. It's just, I mean, all over in Calabasas. And it's so much appreciated, all the time and effort it took for you to come here, and we're so grateful for that. Having all the people in the one room that you, all your friends, all your family, everybody that you love is so special. Of course, we're missing Papa and Grandpa, who, you know, they just adored you, and we just, you know, we're just so sorry they're not here, but we have everybody in our room that who loves you guys, except for them. So I want to take some time to just thank certain people. I'll miss some people, but I really appreciate all that it took to put this event together. And I'd like to thank the wedding coordinator. I'd like to thank all the women and girls who put on the showers. We did such a beautiful job with the showers, the luncheons, the nails, the hair, the pedicures, man, whatever it was. Unbelievable. To all the vendors, photographers, videographers, the great band that's going to be performing tonight, the bridesmaids, you are so gorgeous, each and every one of you. And now, I've only had two drinks. You are just more special in your heart. You mean so much to Kaslin. You mean so much to Mary and I, because you guys are such good friends. Mary has that same core, and you guys have that same thing going, and you will forever. And I just can't thank you enough for being with Kaslin, being friends of hers, and just showing her the way. So stay with her. Be with her. I know she loves you more than anything, and thank you for that. The groomsmen, you too. You have a bigger task, actually. it's great getting to meet all you guys. Wonderful guys. And Andy, you know, you're gonna need them along the way just to help guide you. Keep them accountable, guys. Do the same for them. And it's just been wonderful meeting you all. You know, there's so many great acts of kindness that have come out of this. And it's just hadn't gotten unnoticed and so appreciated. I needed my teeth done because I had a chipped tooth. And Dr. Blake Mueller out of Westlake Village, my buddy, brought me in on a Wednesday. He's off on every Wednesday. Two Wednesdays in a row he brought me in, and he bonded them for free as a gift, as a surprise. I mean, it's the little things like that that all my friends calling me, texting me, it's just really heartfelt and very much appreciated. But I'd also like to give special thanks to the 54 people who RSVP'd no. The very, very special people at Nordstrom's and Bloomingdale's. I never knew you could be so accommodating and so nice. I mean, wonderful. I want to thank American Express for their patience over the next couple months. But on a serious note, I want to thank Tom and Diane. You guys have taught us how to be in-laws. You guys have set the bar. You took us in from the beginning. We have a key to your house. We've been to several parties. The showers you put on, the rehearsal dinner, the contribution to this wedding has been unbelievable. We are just so thankful. So I just want you to know from the bottom of our hearts, Mary and I have talked this over, and you know that the hardest thing about first being married is where are we going to spend the holidays, because everybody has their tradition, right? So honestly, Mary and I are going to allow you to have Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. Okay? Mazel tov. L'chaim. All right. Kaz, Andy. Today was just a beautiful day, and it was a very emotional day. And today I took some time and I went down to the beach and I prayed for you guys. I just had a beautiful prayer about you guys. I prayed for your future. And it was just a beautiful time on the beach, just in solitude. And I just pray that your future is everything that my mom and dad's were and that mine and Mary's are. And I just know it's right, and I know it's great. And it was just a wonderful time. A little solitude with God, and he really spoke to me. And then I had to pray that I'm down at a clothing optional beach, and I'm trying to pray. And why is it every time I go to a nude beach, it's nothing but 65-year-old overweight men? There's never, it's just the way it is. It's the strangest thing. I was in Europe, the same thing happened. It's like, and then I had to pray I made it up the stairs, because that beach, that thing is like 3,000-foot elevation. But I made it, so. Anyway, Kaz, I'll just never forget when Andy, you called, as you call every morning, and Mary hung up the phone, and she goes, honey, she's having coffee with this guy today, and there's something different. And I don't know what it is, but I just hear it in her voice and I feel it. And sure enough, it's all working out. And, 4 years later, Andy, we've been waiting a long time for you to... We had the most beautiful lunch with him. He took us out to lunch. We knew it was going to happen. I'm like, come on, let's get it on. He's talking for like half an hour. Before he got the words out of his mouth, I said, yes. Almost done, sorry. It's true, good point. I'll talk as long as I want. I guess I've cried enough today, so I'm not tearing up right now, but it's so much easier giving your daughter away to someone you truly love. And Andy, you just make it easy to give her away, because I've been the one there for her. I'm her protector. I take care of her. And now, I still will, but you're the main man. And I'm so grateful for that. People have always asked me, oh, your daughter's getting married. Do you like the guy? And my standard answer has been, from day one, I couldn't have handpicked anyone better. And Kaz, we've talked so much, we've said so much, I'm not even sure what else to say. You've just always made me very proud. Every single decision you have ever made has been well thought out and correct. You've always been there for me, and at your young age has helped me with so many life decisions. We truly have a unique relationship, we truly do. One that I cherish more than anything. And as I texted you yesterday, I'm sorry, but Andy can never love you as much as I do. So, as one of the great orators of our time once said at my wedding, Chuck Friedlander, Andy, I only ask that you love her half as much as we do. So with that, let's get this party over with. You guys get upstairs and make us some grandchildren.
Ken? Gotta hold on easy as I let you go. Gonna tell you how much I love you, though you think you already know. I remember I thought you
wrapped in pink so soft and warm. You've had me wrapped around your finger since the day you were born.
Give it up for Kenny.
My little girl. When you were in trouble, that crooked little smile nailed my heart a stone. I look at you, I've turned around and you've always grown. Sometimes you're asleep, I whisper, I love you in the moonlight at your door. As I walk away,
let's hear it. Yeah. And now we'd like to invite onto the floor Diane and Andy for the mother and son dance.
Well, put your hands together for him, huh? Come on.
There'll be days like this.
Happy.
When there's no one complaining, there'll be days like this. Everything falls into place like the flick of a switch. Well, my mama told me there'd be days like this. When you don't need to worry, there'll be days like this. When no one's in a hurry, there'll be days like this. When you don't get betrayed,
woo,
by that old Judas kiss. My mama told me there'll be days like this. When you don't need an answer, there'll be days like this. When you don't need a chance, there'll be days like this. When all the parts of the puzzle start to look like they fit, then I must remember.
All right, we need everybody's help. We need everybody to help join us on the dance floor. Right now, we're going to kick this party off. Well, everybody, put your hands together for the mother-son dance. But we need everybody to join in right now. Come on, y'all. We need your help. Let's kick this party.
All right, that was Paolo. Y'all ready to party out there? Somebody make some noise.